Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create the look of crumpled paper from scratch. Before we begin, if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please take a moment to hit that subscribe button so you know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials. Create a new document by pressing Ctrl or Command N, or by going to File and New. Make the width 1920 pixels, the height 1080 pixels, and the resolution 150 pixels per inch. If the color box isn't white, open the background contents list and click white. Click Create or press Enter or Return. We'll unlock the layer so we can modify it. Change its blend mode to Difference. Check your foreground and background colors. If they aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. If the colors are inverted, press X. Open your gradient tool. At the top are the gradient fill options. We can either click the reflected gradient or the diamond gradient, since they'll both work for this effect. However, I prefer the diamond gradient. Make the mode difference and the opacity 100%. Place your cursor outside the document and drag your tool across at any angle, then release. Continue to make multiple passes at various angles until there's an interesting complexity of intersecting tones. The more passes we make, the more crumpled our paper will be. We'll convert it into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. To do this, click the icon at the upper right and click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Stylize, and Emboss. Make the angle 135 degrees, the height 6 pixels, and the amount 200%. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 1.5 pixels. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Levels. Make the input black level amount 30, the input midtone amount 0.9, and the input white level amount 150. Shift-click layer 0 to make it active as well, and convert the two layers into one smart object. Open your rectangular Marquee tool. Drag out a rectangular selection approximately this size. We'll center it by going to Select and Transform Selection. Go to View. If Snap isn't checked, click it to activate it. Drag the selection until it snaps to the center. It'll snap in place because we have Snap checked. Press Enter or Return to accept its position. We'll convert it into a quick mask by pressing Q on our keyboard. Open your polygonal lasso tool and place your cursor on a corner of the quick mask. Click and drag the tool at slight angles to points where your paper is creased. Make sure your paths stay inside the quick mask. Continue to make connecting paths at slight angles. Connect the tool back to the first point to complete the path. You'll see a small circle added to the tool icon to let you know the path is complete. Release your mouse or pen, which converts the path into a selection. Invert the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command Shift I. We'll fill the inverted selection by pressing Alt or Option plus Delete. Press Q on your keyboard, which does two things. It hides the quick mask and inverts the selection. Click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection. We'll make a new layer under it by Ctrl or Command clicking the new layer icon. We'll fill it with 50% gray by pressing Shift plus the F5 key at the top of your keyboard to open the fill window. Open the contents list and click 50% gray. Make the paper layer active and press Ctrl or Command T to open your Transform tool. Go to any corner and press Alt or Option as you drag it in approximately this much. Go to a bottom corner and press Ctrl Alt Shift on Windows or Command Option Shift on a Mac as you drag it out to about here. Go to any corner and size it to fit the document comfortably, then press Enter or Return. Lastly, we'll add a shadow at the bottom of the paper. Make a new layer under the active layer. Open your brush tool and brush picker. Pick a soft, round brush. The size is 30 pixels, the hardness is 0%, and the opacity and flow are both 100%. Place your cursor so the middle of it is halfway along the edge of the paper and just inside the corner. Press and hold the Shift key as you drag across the brush tool to just inside the opposite corner. Pressing Shift kept our cursor perfectly horizontal. Reduce its opacity to 25%. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.